Lesson 1. Biology is the science of life. The word biology comes from two Greek words, bio, meaning life, and logos, the study of. So biology therefore means the study of life. Living things include stuff like bacteria, amoeba, fungi, plants, and animals, including you. In order to be more specific, rather than define biology as the study of life, we'll define it as the science of life. So that begs the question, what is science? So what is science? Science is a thing, and it's also something we do. The products of science include the facts and knowledge that we get from doing the act of science, the process of science. Facts and knowledge are something we can study and something we can add to as we do the process of science. That's the action part. The process of science includes trial and error, technical methods, and the scientific method. Trial and error is like the process of elimination. So if you were to have a bunch of keys and you had to figure out how to unlock a door, you would have to go through each key in order to figure out which one opens the door. That's trial and error. Eventually you'd get the right one that would open the door. Technical methods are more like a recipe. So if you were going to the science lab at your school, and you were to follow a lab that was written for you, that would be a technical method that you could use to study science. The last thing is the scientific method. This is an orderly series of steps that scientists use to answer a question. And there are a couple main parts. The scientific method is made up of a bunch of steps that you can see here. Step 1 is forming a question. What do you want to know? For example, you might ask the question, where do bacteria live? In order to answer this question, you would have to do some research, which is step 2. By doing research, I might figure out that bacteria like moist environments. Because I've figured that out, now I can form a hypothesis, which is step 3. A hypothesis is kind of like a prediction. It's a possible answer to the question that you've asked. So I might hypothesize that bacteria live in toilets. In order to test my hypothesis, I have to move on to step 4, which is actually doing an experiment. So I might go into a bathroom and swab the toilet, put that swab on a petri dish, and see if any bacterial colonies grow. Once I've left my colonies to grow, I'll make my observations, which is step 5. Were there any bacterial colonies that grew? If so, how many? Once I've collected my data, then I can move on to start step 6, which is analyzing my data. Once I've analyzed my data, then I'll draw a conclusion. In this case, the conclusion might be that yes, bacteria do grow in toilets. I'm not done yet. Once I've drawn my conclusion, I still have to communicate that conclusion to the peers in my field of study so that they know what I found out and they can build on my knowledge.